You're tuned into Toby Talks, episode 11, How to Succeed from Failing in Nursing School. So while I was in nursing school, I was dealing with a lot. Just like everyone else, you're dealing with friendships, relationships, financial situations, family drama, you know, everything that comes with life. But for me, I spent a lot of my time journaling what I was going through. And sometimes it was inconsistent, I'm not gonna lie, because nursing can be a lot where you're just happy if you got to pass the test and got to your clinicals on time. But for this episode, I actually went to go find my journal because I remember I journaled about my experience of when I failed in nursing school. And by the way, this was my second attempt. So I had failed a second time in a different program and I was devastated. So I actually want to read to you guys what I actually wrote in my journal during that time. And it seems like I had missed a couple of entries because I clearly titled this one Fall 2011/Spring 2012. So I guess this is a nice overview. So listen in. I was at the end of our third semester in nursing school when me, Kara, Ashley, and Inez found out what we made in our classes. Ashley and Kara already previously found out they failed psych, and we were all on edge about med surg. Well, we found out we all failed except Inez. We were devastated. I cried so hard that night because I worked my butt off that semester and didn't pass. But not knowing, God had something in store and set up for me. After dealing with the shock of having to retake the course and pushing graduation a whole semester back, I received a call from United Regional Hospital for employment. I was so excited to work for the hospital because it gave me the encouragement to continue on for the next semester, plus a financial gain, where I was able to quit all three of my other jobs, which was tutoring, working at the Grove, and working for MSU. On top of that, Lord, that was my first semester without being with my ex, which emotionally was hard for me to grasp at the time, because I truly believed he was the one, and we were gonna get married, and it was going to be a beautiful bliss. But Lord, you had other plans for me that I couldn't see at the time. Well, as spring semester went by, I retook MedSurg, which made a whole lot of sense because I worked as a tech on the MedSurg unit floor. Plus, I really helped me grab a lot that I didn't focus enough on in the last semester. You also blessed me with a new car, a Honda Accord named Champagne, which I adore so much. RIP Sophia. That was my last car, y'all. She will be missed. So even though I was messed up and distraught by the ending of last semester, you have blessed me more than I can imagine this past spring. Thank you, Father. A quote that I wrote from the Bible, Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good and not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope. Whew, that was a lot. Y'all, let's go ahead and hop into this conversation. Let's hop in this, y'all. So today I want to talk about three things I did that helped me succeed after failing in nursing school. So before we hop into that, I have to give you a backstory about how I got into my second failure. So I first went to a nursing school, first attempt, and I didn't do so well in my first semester. I ended up failing a class, and the class was also attached to a lab. So that was two Fs that hit my GPA, and it sunk like to a 1 point something. Like, I've never been hit that hard ever. And the class weighed a lot. It was like 8-credit course class. So at that time, after I failed my first time, I decided to change my major and pursue psychology, which I really loved, and a minor in business communication. And from there, once I graduated, I was going to apply to the accelerated nursing program. So I was actually in my last semester, or semester before my last, before I graduated in my psych degree, when two of my friends, I have to give a huge shout out to them, Gabby and Faith, they were pushing me to apply to another nursing program. And I was like, no, I'm good. I already got another plan set up. I don't want to do it. And literally, they kept pushing me to the T. And I remember one night in my room, Gabby came to me and she was like, just do it. Nothing's going to happen if you just apply. Just do it. Because, you know, at that time, they were all applying for different nursing programs. And we all wanted to go to the same school together. So I literally applied last minute. When I mean last minute, I mean like it was 11 o'clock. Deadline was like 11:59. And I end up applying to another nursing program. And I, ironically, and by the craziness of God and how he works, I was the only one that got into the school that I applied for. And that was at Midwestern State University. And it was like crazy because I did not see this coming. And I had no plans of going to another nursing school. But let me tell y'all, when that acceptance letter came in, Toby packed up her bags. All right. She packed them up quick. And I headed out. I went to the next nursing program because two things. One, of course, like I stated on, I think, episode 2 or 3 about how to get into nursing school, or if you're about that life, that you really have to think about your financial aspect. And if I was to graduate in my psychology degree, I would not have like the other grants that I get as an undergrad. So I decided to not graduate and go to the nursing program and pursue my actual dream of being a nurse. So now we're currently in my second attempt nursing program. It's a 5-semester course. And I was in my 3rd semester. So 1st semester was crazy. I passed. I was so happy. 2nd semester, crazy. I passed. So happy. 3rd semester was tough. I'm not going to lie to you. It was a very rough semester. I was working a lot of jobs. And I reestablished NAACP at my university. So I was a president of an organization. I was also proactive in other organizations. And I went through the biggest breakup of my life. I never actually had a breakup that big and that hard that shook me. And that was one. So I was going through all that before I started my 3rd semester. And to my knowledge, I thought, you know, we studied our butt off. And I had a really good group of friends who were there and very supportive. And the last day of finals, like finals was tough, y'all. We were studying all hours of the night. We were doing dance moves to keep us awake. I mean, we were doing a lot just to make sure we studied and we passed. And grades were coming in at that time. Was the last day of school or something like that. And I looked and I found out that I made a 73.9. And many people don't know, but at the time, our nursing program was if you made anything below a 74, you practically failed. Like it was a letter D, but you had to make a C and above to pass, right? Yeah. So I made a 73.9 something. And of course, nursing schools are so disrespectful because they will not round up by a fraction of a decimal. So my heart sunk when I found out I failed. Like, I was just like, oh my God, I cannot believe this is happening again. This is my second attempt and I failed again in the 3rd semester. And I was distraught. I'm not gonna lie, it emotionally shook me. I remember being depressed for like 2 weeks straight and I didn't want to eat. I didn't want to talk to nobody. I was just in this like moody mindset. I was so sad. I just didn't know what to do from there. But luckily, I had the grace of I only failed one course at that time. And in nursing school, I'm not sure if the processes have changed, but you have 2 chances. If you fail 2 courses, you're immediately out the program. So luckily I only failed 1 that semester, but still, like, I don't know anyone who ever been through failing already once at another school and then you're coming again, you automatically feel like, oh my gosh, nursing school isn't for me, or God doesn't want me to be a nurse, or, you know, you start thinking of all the negative things like, man, this maybe isn't for me, or maybe I'm not called to do this, or whatever the case may be. Girl, I was thinking, girl and boy, whoever's listening to this, I was thinking of all of those things at once. And that's my tip number 1 for you guys, is definitely make sure you deal with the emotional baggage of failing. I know sometimes when we fail, we try to just pick up and move on as if nothing happened. But it is an emotional thing because you know you put in your hard work, your time, your effort to succeed at something, and it doesn't go well. And I think a lot of times we don't acknowledge that emotionally, and we like to just pick back up and keep going. Or we stay too long in that distraught moment that it doesn't allow us to think of what our next plan is. So for me, the one step that really, really helped me was dealing with the emotional baggage of failing. So I want to encourage you, if you failed, it's okay to cry. It's okay to be sunken. It's okay to be shook. It's okay to not feel like doing anything and you're just overwhelmed with that emotion of you didn't make it or you didn't do well. That's normal. Like, if you're not even feeling that, then I think something's wrong with you. I don't know. Everyone's different. But for me, I just want to tell you and encourage you that if you fail, address that emotional baggage. Like, cry. Shoot, shout, scream, throw a book, shoot, throw a lot of them books, because there's some books heavy. Throw them, kick them, don't rip them because they're expensive, but get it all out, you know, and have a good support group that are willing to give you a shoulder to cry on and give you encouragement to move forward from that emotional baggage that you're dealing with failing. So I went through that for a couple of weeks. And luckily it was during the winter season. So we were out of school and we had to start back school until next year in January. So I had enough time to deal with all that emotional baggage. But the good thing about dealing with that was I was able to accept my failure. And that is step number two. After you've gone over your emotional baggage, you've cried it out, you've gotten out of your spirit, you've gone through your depressed stage, get up, wipe your tears, get unshook, and accept it. Accept that you failed. Own it. Don't be ashamed of it. Yeah, you failed, but guess what? You got a second chance or an opportunity to find another way. And for me, my opportunity was the fact that I had the grace of taking the class again. I didn't fail two courses. I wasn't kicked out. So I had the grace to repeat. And yes, I know it is annoying to think of having to sit back in a class, hear the same professor, get the same lecture. And now you're sitting in the class with like all these students that you didn't start with. So you almost feel like an outsider, because I felt that way. And I do want to apologize to my nursing class 2013. I think in that semester that I retook that class, I was a B-I-T-T-H. I was not trying to make friends. I had a mean mug every day because I was like mad upset that I had to do this all over again. But luckily by fourth semester, I had gotten over it. But girl and boy, during third semester, I was a hot mess. Like, I didn't want to talk to nobody. I was just there to relearn, rehear these slides again, and do better. So, like I said, I owned it. I was happy to know that I had a second chance. In that second chance, I restarted this program. I got back into the class. I got to retake it. But the benefit of that was during the winter time when I was going through my depressed stage and all that, I had applied to a local hospital to get a job. And I got a call back during that time of the winter season. And I was so excited because I ended up working as a tech on the med-surg unit. And with me accepting my failure, working as a tech on that med-surg unit actually helped me excel in me repeating the course. So my second advice, which was accepting your failures and owning it, is saying that, okay, I know I didn't succeed well that first time. I'm owning it. Now let me figure out what I can do better. So that's going to lead us into my third thing that I did that helped me succeed in my failure. And that was identify what caused me to fail. So let me table back to the fact that I got this job at the local hospital, United Regional, and I was so excited about that. The reason being was this hospital, the amount that I was getting paid would allow me to quit three of my other jobs because it was very flexible. I can work a certain amount of hours a week versus the three jobs that I was working, they were all like part-time jobs. I was actually working four jobs. I was working another one as well, but that one was PRN. So I was working as a tutor at a high school, a local high school. I was also working at The Grove, which is an apartment complex for students at that time, or community. So I would work for them, and that was how I got my free housing, y'all. So be smart on that. If you can find a job and work in an apartment complex where you got to pay rent, just work your hours, go ahead and do it. And then my third job, I was a student coordinator for MSU, the Multicultural Center. So doing those three and a PRN job in Dallas at a children's hospital there, I was like overwhelmed. And that's where I identified what caused me to fail. I was working too many jobs. I was being pulled in so many areas. I was also a president of an organization, NAACP, on my campus. And I also was a part of like two other organizations on campus as well. So I was really being stretched to the T on my time. So that wasn't really allowing me to have too much time to study. But it's also hard if you're a nurse and you're financially taking care of yourself and your student bills and your living expenses, that sometimes those things can play a role in why you didn't succeed. And trying to trim down how you can still have the financial resources you need, but also make sure that you're not extending yourself too much. So with that gain of that job, I was able to quit all three of my other jobs, which I love the tutoring, but the timing was just, I wasn't able to do it. So I was able to quit those jobs later on towards the spring semester. And I also even got a brand new car, and it wasn't even an option. Like, that car happened out of nowhere because my poor little rinky dinky car, which I love so much, literally stopped on me in mid semester. So I needed a brand new car, and God was able to work that out. Even with my monthly payments, it was all affordable with my new job working at the hospital. So I identified one thing was I was overstretching myself with my jobs. Two, I had went through a horrible breakup right before my fall semester had started. So I didn't really let go of that emotional baggage. So it was really hard to study sometimes, because then you'll have that, you know, those reoccurring feelings that come with a relationship when you've ended it out of nowhere. And so that was also something else I identified. I didn't properly heal or have enough time to get over that breakup and having to start into school and be focused and ready. And two, I was working too many jobs and stretching myself out too much. And I just want you to know that when you identify what caused you to fail, you can't jump back from failing if you haven't figured out what went wrong. And that's what I really want to encourage you. What went wrong in your failures? Was it that you had too many things that were getting in the way of you studying? You had emotional baggage that was carrying along throughout the semester that didn't help you focus? Those are the things that I identified. And because I identified those things, it helped me in my spring semester focus. I had one job. I was over the breakup by then. I had a brand new car. God was really opening doors for me to see. And I was starting to get that hands-on experience working as a tech in MedSurg that truly helped. So I just want to kind of recap, because I kind of started sounding like I'm gibbering and jabbering, but I want to recap on what helped me succeed in my failure. And that was, one, dealing with the emotional baggage of failing. Deal with it. Get it out the door. Two, accepting your failures. Accept it. Own it. You failed. So did everybody else. Heck, Oprah failed. And look at her. She's a billionaire. And three, identified what caused you to fail. Focus in on what mistakes you made during that attempt. Identify it and work on those things so you don't do it again and it doesn't hinder your success moving forward. So for me, those are the three things that I did that helped me get through my second failure in nursing school. And I also want to encourage you out there, anyone who's listening to this, that everyone who is successful in anything goes through a failure. That is normal. That is just a part of life. No one goes in perfectly knowing like, bam, boom, I'm going to get this done and it's going to be perfect. There are going to be roadblocks. There are going to be stumbling blocks. There are going to be areas that you didn't see that comes out of nowhere. So I just want to encourage you that failure is all a part of learning, But the successful part of it is how you get back up and how you accomplish and keep going. And it took me a while to get to this point to even share this with you guys, because I never thought that my failure meant anything. Like, I knew for me, it was like, oh, a hiccup and whatever, but I never thought or saw myself sharing this with the world. And the reason why I'm so comfortable to share it with the world and share it with you guys listening is because I knew that without my failure, I wouldn't be where I am here today. Loving nursing, loving inspiring those who are trying to achieve nursing or who are already in the nursing field. I never saw myself in this point. So this excites me so much to know that I can share this with you guys. And I want you to know that I, Tobi, I am personally rooting for you. And let me tell y'all something. I had posted probably last week or a week, 2 weeks ago, about how I got into my nursing program. The first attempt with a 3.1 and then the second attempt with a 2.5. So y'all, today I went scrambling through all my journals, and I keep everything. I kept all my transcripts and everything. I found my transcript from my previous university that I needed to apply to the second attempt university. And I want to apologize to y'all because I lied. I did not get accepted into my second attempt nursing program with a 2.5. Y'all, I am holding the paper right now. I want y'all to hear that. Apparently, I actually got back into my second attempt nursing program with a 2.0 current GPA and a 2.1 cumulative GPA. Y'all, I shouted. I literally was like, babe, guess what? I done failed and I got back in with a 2.1. And the reason why I'm so excited about that, because that lets me know that anything is possible, no matter what the stupid GPA requirements are that all the colleges have. It was possible, y'all. I got back in with a 2.1. And let me tell you something. The reason why it was a 2.1, if y'all recall, my first nursing school program, I got two Fs. And an F on your GPA, it can really sink your GPA down low. So I had two Fs, and one was for an 8-hour course. So it really hit my GPA so bad that the rest of the semester and the following, when I changed my classes to go into psych, I had to hustle and build my GPA to a 2.1. And that was when I had no desire of even applying back into nursing school. But look at God. I had friends who were my encouragement. Even when I was stubborn and didn't want to listen to apply to a nursing program, they pushed me, they encouraged me. I did it with a GPA of a 2.1 when their requirements was like a 3.0 and above. And I know it was because I was very proactive, and I think I wrote, I don't even know if I wrote some kind of letter describing what happened, and I made sure I had a good letter of standing from the current university I was attending before I sent out the applications. But I want you to know, and I want you to be inspired, that no matter what, if God is pushing you and you have friends encouraging you, do it and let everything else take care of itself. So I just want to make sure that I stated that. I am so sorry that I posted that. I thought I got in with a 2.5, but this transcript said I got in with a 2.1. And that makes me even more excited. Like, I cannot just, I will repost and correct that. But I hope this encourages anyone out there, because I know I'm not the only one that has failed out the nursing program or has failed in the program and you don't know what to do from there. Okay? So my story is a little bit different because I didn't fall out the program. I still had another attempt. But for those who have failed out the program, I definitely want you to catch episode 3, which is I fell out of nursing school, now what? I actually got to interview my very good friend, Ashley, who was with me the semester that we found out that we failed. So her and my friend Cara actually failed psych and med-surg that semester. But if you listen to her episode, she gives you the best information on how she is now an RN BSN nurse. And she walks you through what she did when she failed and how she got back up. So I really hope y'all enjoyed today's conversation, because I did. And I know the conversation was with myself, but I was visually envisioning y'all in the background, I guess. So if you have any questions, comments, or you just need some encouragement, hit me up. I am here. I love to talk, but I also love to inspire, and I love to hear your stories of what you're going through. And I want you to know that you are not alone. So don't forget, the way to come up from a failure, y'all, is please remember, 1, deal with the emotional baggage of failing. 2, accept your failures. And 3, identify what caused you to fail and leave the rest up to God. Okay. So I love you guys. I can't wait for our next episode. You don't want to miss that, of course. So feel free to hit me up. You already know it's TobiTalks@TobiTodge.com. Again, that's TobiTalks@TobiTodge.com. Or you can follow me on Instagram, which is Toby.talks. Or go ahead and hit up my website at www.TobiTodge.com. I'll be talking to you guys later.